Hi guys, welcome to HOPCorn. In today's episode, I will be looking at the journey of the maverick Indian film director Anurag Kashyap, who is regarded as an auteur of our times. Guys, in case you're wondering what that is, auteur is a person equivalent to an author of a novel, matlab jinka ek distinct or recognizable style or thematic preoccupation hoti hai. Matlab jaise aap gaane ke musical arrangement sunke identify kar lete hain, unka music composer Rehman ya Ajay Atul hain, waise hi hamari umr mein ek jhalk mein hi pata chal jata hai ki parde par kis author ki picture chal rahi hai putar ji. तो ऑटर कश्यप को उनके अर्ली 2000s के पायनियरिंग एफर्ट इन द देसी स्पेस ऑफ फिल्म मेकिंग के कारण पूजनीय माना जाता है. कश्यप्स कैरेक्टर्स हिट यू इन द गट विद देयर रियलनेस. उनकी टेक्निक बीइंग वेरी इम्प्रोवाइजेशनल, एम्प्लॉइंग गिरिला टेक्निक्स, मतलब कि लो बजट छोटा क्रू, सीन्स दैट आर शॉट इन रियल लोकेशंस विदाउट वार्निंग एंड परमिट्स ऑफ कोर्स. बोले तो लेस शोशा पर कॉन्टेंट में नो धोखा. और तीन बहुत जरूरी पॉइंट्स. पहली, हिज फीमेल कैरेक्टर्स इन द फिल्म, दे आर क्वर्की, ब्रीफ बट एक्सट्रीमली इम्पैक्टफुल एंड पिविटल टू द नैरेटिव. हिज रेप्यूटेशन फॉर नॉट स्टिकिंग टू हिज स्क्रिप्ट एंड मेकिंग कॉन्स्टेंट इम्प्रोवाइजेशंस इन हिज एक्टर्स डायलॉग्स ऑन सेट इज ऑल्सो नॉट अननोन. लास्टली और तीसरा पॉइंट, कश्यप की फिल्म में लार्जली उनके एक्टर्स आर हेवली इंटॉक्सिकेटेड. मतलब आप ड्रग का नाम लो और दे सी इट, दे लाइक इट, दे वॉन्ट इट, दे गॉट इट. Excessive drugs, smoke or alcohol consumption, personal guilt, extreme rage or arrogance are just some of their staple features. और यही उनके अंदर की राम गोपाल वर्मा की आग leads them into घातक situations. Without further ado, let's just look at his filmography. Anurag Kashyap started his career by co-writing the blockbuster hit Satya of 1998, directed by Ram Gopal Varma. It was the first of gangster trilogy about organized crime in India. The film follows Satya, played by Cheri Chakravarti, an immigrant who comes to Mumbai looking for a job, befriends Bhiku Mathre, played by Manoj Bajpayee, and is drawn into the Mumbai underworld. इस कल्ट फिल्म को 20 साल हो चुके हैं, विच इज सपोज टू हैव चेंज्ड द फेट ऑफ कश्यप, प्रोवाइडिंग हिम द मच नीडेड किक स्टार आफ्टर द इनिशियल स्ट्रगल इन द इंडस्ट्री. हाउएवर, कश्यप्स डेब्यू फिल्म वॉज पांच, दैट केम आउट इन द ईयर 2003. Film was loosely based on the 1976-77 Joshi Abhyankar serial murders in Pune and had K.K. Menon, Vijay Maurya and Tejaswini Kolhapure in lead roles. Ye Anurag ki pehli film thi aur censor board ne object kiya film mein violence, depiction of drug abuse and bad language par. But this is what will be the first of several many times that censor will raise objection to Anurag's bold choices. Next was the much talked and once again much controversial film Black Friday that released in the year 2007. Black Friday is one film jo ki aapko ek samay par myriad of emotions ka samna karayegi, namely shock, dismay, awestruck, disgust as well as helplessness jo ki apne aap mein ek bhari bharkam achievement hai of the filmmaker. Walking the bloody line between realism and recreation, it demonstrated that the most compelling stories often lie within the investigative stillness of actual events and that filmmaking can transcend mediums if it commits to being just a medium. Film delve karti hai in the aftermath of the infamous 1993 bomb blast based on Hussein Zaidi's insightful novel. The narrative was explosive, much like the issue that was being dealt with. Perhaps it was the destiny that a film about an explosion is what enabled the filmmaker to finally, at long last, burst onto a nation's screen. Film ki release was held up for 2 years by the Central Board of Film Certification because of the pending verdict of the case at that time, but it was finally released in 2007 to widespread critical appreciation. Moving on to No Smoking of 2007, people usually argue it was too radical, too far ahead of its time. Par mere khayal se, a film has to be understood to be misunderstood. The part-wicked, mostly arrogant No Smoking was a film school-style rush of blood for the maker who, perhaps reeling from the joy of finally having secured a theatrical release, went fully mad on unsuspecting viewers with the psychological madness of this John Abraham starrer. It might be about a man put through random hell to quit smoking, but it was largely about a filmmaker defiantly expressing a decade-long nightmare of random roadblocks and shell projects. You can call it Anurag Kashyap ki bhadas, in short, guys. Next, I simply have a magical surprise for you. Magical being the operative word. When we talk about Anurag Kashyap, what usually pops up in your head? A dark, gritty thriller, an edge-of-the-seat crime drama set in a rustic land, or a coming-of-the-age gangster film. Right? Arey bolo, right na? But what if I were to tell you that the next film Kashyap directed in the year 2007 was a mighty surprise. Mighty, magical. Yes. Hanuman. I mean the film Return of Hanuman. His first and only animated film is by no means a forgotten one. In fact, ye ek bahut hi unique interpretation thi of the Indian mythology for the purpose of environmental education. And not to miss the bold irreverence. Devi Devta jo ki laptops use kar rahe hain, Hanuman ji turning Mount Rushmore into the faces of the Ramayan. Film mein 70s ki movies aur political and pop culture reference bhi thi. I remember having a blast myself when I saw this one a decade ago. Well guys, 2009 was again a monumental year for Anurag Kashyap cinema lovers. This was the year of aitihasik films Devdi and Gulal. Jahan ek taraf Gulal ne explore kiye themes such as pursuit of power, quest for legitimacy, perceived injustices and hypocrisy of the powerful, wahi Devdi, which was 12th film adaptation of the Bengali novel of the same name, ne deal kiye with the issue of patriarchy and marriages jiske liye family ties ko aksar negotiate kiya jata hai for the game of power and honor. While Gulal was set in present-day Rajasthan, Devdi is set in contemporary Punjab and Delhi. Although Gulal ke case mein critics ke reviews were favorable, parantu Devdi was unanimously well taken by media, audience as well as critics. Gulal's miraculous release was a result of this brazen Devdas adaptation catapulting Kashyap from indie masiha to mainstream matador. Rather than depicting modern addiction, Devdi embodied its high through a lethal cocktail of imagery, sound and wild spirit. The convergence of different artists, Abhay Deol, musician Amit Trivedi and go-to cinematographer Rajiv Ravi at a common fearless peak in their journeys is as much a testament to Kashyap's creative doggedness as is to his eye for the undetonated hunger. Devdi Kashyap ke liye undoubtedly ek breakthrough picture thi, but also for our desi audience jinhone prove kar ditta that Hindi films could actually succeed when they are told from the innards of a desi land. Ab main monumental pictures ki baat karu and legend, wait for it, Dari, Gangs of Wasseypur 1 and 2 ko kaise na yaad karu. Ekdo references ki bhai, what was such a big deal about these? Part 1 and Part 2 of Wasseypur thi certified mafia masterpiece. So, bhai, I request you guys to watch them ASAP if you haven't already. Anurag's compression of time, conflicted sense of continuity and lavish expansion of generational politics, Sneha Khanwalkar's eclectic score, evolved sense of desi humor turned Wasseypur's mayhem into a reverential template future cults to follow. But tough deal to thi going one up on part one jo ki thi complete package. It seemed like Anurag Kashyap had poured every bit of his explosive creativity into that first film while establishing power battle in the coal belt badlands of Dhanbad. Agar aapko part 1 ne entertain kiya tha, to saath hi saath lahu muh bhi laga diya tha. Which is why you sat salivating before the release of part 2. But the clever thing that Kashyap had done was perhaps the fact that he made both films as a single 5-hour project before opting to release them in two parts. Matlab, if you guys want, you can also do color as dono din ka kaam in office aaj hi and maybe send all the work tomorrow calling it part 2. I mean, just a suggestion. But you know what guys, whenever we talk about Anurag Kashyap's films, we usually miss out a masterstroke that he may have hit in the year 2013 with film Murabba in Bombay Talkies 2013 starring Mukkabas to be Vineet Singh. Guys, the film is so funny, it is so heartwarming ki jab maine ise pehli baar dekha tha, I couldn't help but wonder why it may have got submerged under heavier and most discussed names like Devdi and Black Friday. Film Murabba captures the taste of what films mean to us Indians and the importance film stars have in our lives through the eyes of Vijay from Allahabad, who travels to Mumbai to fulfill his ailing father's desire that Vijay meets Bollywood superstar Mr. Amitabh Bachchan, offer and feed him homemade Murabba and bring the remaining half for his father. But speaking of overload, Anurag Kashyap faces financial losses overload in the year 2015 with his first big budget star-studded dream venture, Bombay Velvet. I remember is film ka scene where Ranbir Kapoor, who played the so-called hero Balraj, is having bit of an emotional scene, while Amit Trivedi's melancholy composition gives us the cue to feel remorseful. But the audience still end up laughing. That alone I felt was a problem with the plot. हमारा investment in our hero was near zero, क्योंकि hero पूरे time winner है. और as we all know, हम सब life में winner के बजाय अपने जैसे hustler से connect करते हैं. We all are hustling after all, right? However, I have to say the film's songs are so beautiful. I can listen to them over and over if only we could watch this movie with closed eyes. At least Kashyap was honest enough to reiterate that Karan Johar had always been Kashyap's biggest villain in the film and before it. Wink, wink. Guys, time for a short break. Don't go anywhere. Aaj hum Anurag Kashyap ki films ko discuss kar rahe hain. Be right back. Welcome back, guys. आज हम discuss कर रहे हैं one of the most relevant directors of our times, Anurag Kashyap, and his top films. Next on the list is 2016 की Raman Raghav 2.0. Kashyap's Badlapurish update of Sriram Raghavan's unreleased docudrama about a mythical serial killer is gleefully unhinged, perverse, and entertaining. Nobody inspires Nawazuddin Siddiqui the way Kashyap can. And a career-best performance as a psychopath, how else, pushes the film so hard that the maker virtually tries to restrain it with a feeble chapter-wise narrative. Just for that exquisitely crafted sequence where Ramana holds his sister's family hostage, 2.0 ranks as the director's most visceral cinematic achievement. In that, even his trademark descent into uncontrolled insanity adds to the film's dichotomous palette. Phir aayi 2018 mein Mukkabaz, where Murabba actor Vineet Singh's compelling performance makes him a character to root for and his triumph feels earned. They feel good, unlike the problem that essentially plagued Bombay Velvet. Director Anurag Kashyap double loads the film right from the start, giving us a boxer hero to love, soft-eyed and sincere and spry, while making him worship a someone like Mike Tyson. Kashyap is at his absolute best in Mukkabaz, all heart and heartland, a movie made with a vintage filmy sensibility but highly modern skills, and a story that bleeds. The love is pulpy and the revenge served up with masala. And that treatment takes this vital narrative further. But guys, the one time Kashyap dabbles with genre of romance, and it becomes highly watchable and relevant if that's what a take on modern love stories can be. The film revolves around a love triangle between a spirited young woman, Rumi, played by Tapsee Pannu, her outgoing avara boyfriend, Vicky, played by Vicky Kaushal himself, and a fiancé who's husband material, the pyara pyara Robbie, played by Abhishek Bachchan. Hockey player Rumi manipulates her family for her own gain. She's unapologetic about it. She smokes, chugs drinks, and has sex unapologetically. Her partner in crime is a local guy with tattoos and piercings, the entire Avara package, Vicky Kaushal, in terrific form. Enter good boy Robbie, played by Abhishek Bachchan in a possible comeback, who doesn't talk much but doesn't let that keep him from fighting against all odds to acquire the woman he likes. Guys, if you have thoda extra time at hand this weekend, go and watch this one. You won't be disappointed, I promise. Lastly, shedding some light on the mad, mad craze that is this TV show, Sacred Games.
भगवान को मानते हो? पर कभी सोचा है कि भगवान किसको मानता है?
Streaming on Netflix, अब तो इस popular show का season 2 भी release होने वाला है 15th August को. So in case you're missing out on the pop culture references of Ganesh Gaitonde and Sartaj Singh from this dark thriller, please finish season 1.
Hello, कौन? Gaitonde भाई? भाव कहाँ हुआ?
अपुन किधर था मालूम नहीं. आप उनको बस
और इस पे लिखा है कि जंग का वक्त आ गया. हीरो शिमान आगे सखी
जंग की तैयारी करके बैठे हैं और दुश्मन के बारे में पता ही नहीं आपको।
Kashyap has directed The Old World inhabited by Nawaz, while his director friend and co-founder of his production house Phantom has directed the modern day chase filmed on Saif Ali Khan. Guys, highly recommend this one. So guys, this was all on our list of Kashyap films. You know, very interestingly, Kashyap, who was studying zoology at Hansraj College of Delhi University, one fine day decided to move to Bombay to become a filmmaker after watching Victoria the Sika's Bicycle Thieves. That may have seemed like a bad decision then, because the mad struggle and financial crunch that Kashyap had to endure in the starting few years of his career, but out popped a genius. And as of today, he has been awarded Autre des Arts et des Lettres, Knight of the Order of the Arts and Letters by the French government at 2013 Cannes Film Festival, and a ton of other awards in India and globally. Guys, hope you liked what we had in store for you in today's episode. Keep watching HOPCorn. We have What's That Void coming right after a short break. This is me, Bhavya. Hi guys, welcome to What's That Void. आज हम बात करेंगे पॉपुलर हिंदी फिल्म भूल भुलैया की।
हाँ, वही भूल भुलैया जिसमें विद्या बालन प्लेड मंजुलिका डूइंग आमी जो तुम्हार छिन छिन बिफोर अस एंड अक्षय कुमार एट हिज कॉमिकल बेस्ट एज डॉक्टर आदित्य। छोटे पंडित, राजपाल यादव एंड परेश रावल ऑल्सो एडेड टू द कॉमिक एलिमेंट्स। The film, which was directed by Priyadarshan, starring Akshay, Vidya, Amisha Patel and Shaini Ahuja, will complete 12 years this October. But kya aap jante hain, film mein the kai plot holes. Film mein local princeling Siddharth aur unki patni Avni insist on living in their haunted palace despite warnings from Manoj Joshi. The spirit of a dead dancer and her lover killed by a king are locked up in an out-of-bounds floor of the Haveli. But Avni insists on opening it and weird things soon start happening. तो फिल्म में अवनी यानी बालन हैज डिसोसिएटिव आइडेंटिटी डिसऑर्डर व्हिच वाज द कॉज ऑफ ऑल द पैरानॉर्मल एक्टिविटीज राइट देन हु थ्रू दैट ह्यूज लॉक एट छोटे पंडित राजपाल यादव इफ शी एंड हर हस्बैंड हैडंट इवन अराइव्ड एट द हाउस एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ द स्टोरी इनफैक्ट फिल्म में अक्षय आस्क्ड गोटी टू कम अलॉन्ग विद हिम टू मलिकापुर अ प्लेस इन सेंटर ऑफ द कंट्री तो फिर सॉन्ग अल्लाह हाफिज में उनकी जर्नी के दौरान उनकी बस पर KA और बस के बोर्ड पर कन्नड़ा में क्यों लिखा था All of which pointed to basic factual errors, which by the way, the film was replete with. Well guys, the good news is a decade later, hamare makers thode evolve kar gaye hain and don't give us these many plot holes in a single film. But those that still are, will be discussed right here on What's That Void. See you next week.